Today we are here to talk about the second part of coronary artery disease. Firstly, what is ischemia? Cardiac ischemia is when plaque and fatty matter narrow the inside of your artery so much so that it can't supply oxygen-rich blood to your heart. This can cause heart attacks with or without chest pain and other symptoms. Ischemia happens mostly during eating, excitement or stress, exercise or other exertion, and exposure to cold. CAD can get to a point where ischemia happens even when you're resting. This is, in fact, a medical emergency and may lead to a heart attack. If this happens to you, please call your doctor and go to the emergency room. Ischemia can happen without warning in anyone with heart disease, although it's more common in people with diabetes. Coming to the diagnosis and tests required for CAD. Your doctor can tell you if you have CAD after they learn about your symptoms, medical history and risk factors firstly, and after they do a physical exam. You might also get diagnostic tests so your doctor can find the extent of your CAD and its effect on your heart. This helps them choose the best treatment for you. These tests include cardiac catheterization and angiogram, echocardiogram, electrocardiogram, electron beam CT scan, and exercise stress tests. What are the complications of coronary artery disease? Complications of CAD include abnormal heart rhythm or arrhythmia, when your heart loses its regular rhythm because of damage to your heart or a lack of blood supply. The most common form is called atrial fibrillation. These rhythm problems can cause heart failure or make it worse. An irregular heartbeat might lead to blood clots in your heart, and these can cause a stroke if they reach your brain. Heart attack when your coronary artery is totally blocked, keeping part of your muscle from getting enough oxygen. When blood flow to your heart muscle is blocked, your doctor might call it acute coronary artery syndrome. Heart failure when your heart becomes too weak to supply your body with the blood it needs. This can be because your heart isn't getting enough oxygen and nutrients, or because it was damaged due to a heart attack. So what is the treatment for coronary artery disease? Your treatment may include lifestyle changes. If you smoke, quit. Eat less processed food and change to a diet low in trans fat, salt and sugar. Keep your blood sugar in control if you have diabetes and exercise regularly. Coming to medications, if lifestyle changes aren't enough, you might require medication. The drugs you'll take depend on your situation. If you've been diagnosed with coronary artery disease, you could take aspirin, medications to help keep your cholesterol levels in control like statins, niacin, fibrates and bile acid sequestrants, beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, ranolazine, nitroglycerine, ACE inhibitors, angiotensin II receptor blockers, evolocumab, colchicinin, 0.5 mb of colchicinin. And if medications do not work, you might need surgery and other procedures. Common ones to treat coronary artery disease include balloon angioplasty, coronary artery bypass surgery, or a stent replacement. All these treatments boost blood supply to your heart, but they cannot completely cure coronary artery disease. Doctors are also studying new ways to treat heart disease, including angiogenesis. For angiogenesis, you'll need stem cells and other genetic material through your vein or directly into your damaged heart tissue. It helps new blood vessels grow and go around the clogged ones. Another method is enhanced external counterpulsation, or EECP. People who have long-term angina but haven't gotten any help from nitrate medications or don't qualify for some procedures may find relief in this. It's an outpatient procedure, one where you won't need to be admitted into the hospital, that uses cuffs on the legs that inflate and deflate to boost blood supply to your coronary arteries. Home remedies for coronary artery disease include lifestyle changes that include stopping or quitting smoking, controlling your blood pressure, cholesterol and sugar levels, eating foods that are good for your heart, avoiding alcohol, exercising, keeping a healthy weight, and managing your stress. Keep healthy and stay safe. Thank you very much.